We drive in tense silence, the opposition activists we are with checking to make sure we're not being followed. Down a dark alleyway, we change vehicles. We're in Kafr Susa, in the heart of Damascus. This 21-year-old goes by the pseudonym Abu Marwan. He's a first-year medical student. What he's witnessed, haunting.
Oh, a lot of horrible things, especially my friends. And you know what does it mean when your friends are hurting and you can't do anything? So some people dead between my two hands, and that was really very hard to me, especially my friends. My friends, which I grew up with them since I was 1 year old. And he died because I couldn't do anything, because I have nothing to do.
The losses fueled his determination. 11 months into the uprising, the activists have it down to a science. Spotters are pre-positioned.
More than 20 people, you put them around all the area and the neighborhood to watch if any police or species are coming there.
It's a joke, yeah.
There are posters and other material hidden in a safe house, along with tiny printed leaflets ready to be scattered.
So this is your message to the people that have basically been staying silent, saying, isn't it about time? Haven't they, the regime, filled the land with enough bad things?
Demonstrators move in groups of two or three to avoid attracting attention.
They came very carefully. Now they will go to the other streets and hide.
At the signal, the street erupts into activity. Everyone has a duty. The revolution's flag ripples above the crowd. It's the Syrian flag before the Ba'ath Party took over more than 40 years ago. The leaflets rain down like confetti.
One of the chants that we have been hearing is Labbaik Ya Allah, which loosely translates to mean, we are slaves for you, O Lord. That chant, the activist was saying, has become especially prominent because they feel as if the Arab League, the United Nations, the international community has all abandoned them. They say at this stage, all that they have left is their courage, their determination, and their faith in God.
Every night, the protesters do this. Their numbers are small. Their determination is not.
This is not just a simple thing, a symbol or one demonstration. This is a very big deal. We are facing a bad regime, so we have to do this. And this is one of the hardest things that we have to do daily.
Oh, how nice is freedom, the crowd chants. But every night the protest is short-lived. Just 10 minutes after it started.
That the government might actually be coming in. So now everyone obviously is rushing away as fast as possible.
We have to go faster, right?
They leave the flag behind to make a point that even if just for a while, they did it.
They are just telling us that we have to go faster. The government is moving in from all sides right now.
Another deadly game of cat and mouse in the Syrian capital. Arwa Damon, CNN, Damascus.